Hello, ladies and gents. Lucid here. I would like to invite you once again to participate in a simple experiment. Think about one of your secrets and try picturing it inside your mind. Now, your secret might be something quite simple. The PIN of your credit card, for example. It could be something really embarrassing you have never shared with the world. Or it could be a warm, fuzzy memory you get back to occasionally. Whatever this little secret is, one thing is certain. We all tend to believe that the things inside our head are something private, far beyond the reach of the people around us. That's what we're going to challenge today. We'll explore whether our thoughts, memories, and dreams are as private as we think. Brain scientists have been on a quest to explore every depth of the human mind for ages. There have been many amazing discoveries through the years, and yet a lot of things still remain a mystery. One thing that has been known for a while now is that what we think, feel, dream, and perceive is intimately related to our brain activity. So, in theory, if we measure this activity and find a way to interpret the language of the brain, we should be able to peer into a person's inner world. Scientists have recently started using brain scanners to hack into our minds like never before. Back in 2014, a group of cognitive neuroscientists at Yale used such technique to reconstruct pictures of faces that experimental subjects had been looking at during a brain scan. In the study, 6 participants were shown 300 different faces of various ethnicities and facial expressions. While they were looking at the photos, the researchers scanned their brains with fMRI to record the pattern of brain activity elicited by each of the faces. Next, they fed those patterns of brain activity into a machine learning algorithm designed by programmers as a kind of translator. Its task was to match certain neuroactivity of the observer with certain facial features of the photo being observed. After it has been trained on lots of examples, the algorithm was able to look at a pattern of brain activity and predict the image that produced it. To test the translator, the researchers scanned the same 6 subjects as they looked at 30 new faces that weren't in the original set, and the algorithm created a reconstruction of each face the person saw. The algorithm's performance was assessed through objective computer-based measures and via subjective human-based reports of similarity between the reconstruction and the original picture. Identification accuracy was between 60 and 70%, which is better than chance, but still far from perfect. As wild as this experiment may seem, using brain scans to peer inside people's minds is nothing new. Previous research has shown that it's possible to reconstruct static natural images, handwriting digits, and other visual patterns. But the most impressive one is the 2011 landmark study of Gallant's lab at Berkeley. Using fMRI and sophisticated computer algorithms, similar to those we've described, the researchers succeeded in reconstructing short movie clips from brain activity. The results are far from a perfect representation of the watched movie clips, and yet it's still a great accomplishment for science. Most of the studies so far have focused on the visual system mainly because it's by far the easiest thing to work with. The next step up in degree of difficulty would be predicting people's actions. And as a matter of fact, researchers have had some success in this endeavor. In a 2008 study, Haynes and colleagues asked people to randomly press a button with either their left or right hand. The subjects' brain activity gave their choice away around 7 seconds before they consciously made the decision. And although this decision may not be representative of the complicated choices we face every day, the findings raise profound questions about the nature of the self and free will. But that's a topic for another video. And that's not as interesting as it gets. An even bigger step towards the popular concept of mind reading would be decoding the kind of mental images people see in their mind while daydreaming or falling asleep. And not so long ago, scientists have reported that they've successfully decoded details of people's dreams using brain scans. The dream decoding was pretty primitive though. They could tell someone was dreaming about a car, for instance, but not what kind of car. The details remained a mystery. At this point, you may be experiencing a panicky feeling rushing through your body. But before you reach for your tin hat, keep in mind that scientists are far from being able to dig up those deeply buried childhood memories. The technology is still pretty limited. One of the obstacles it meets are the individual differences, or in other words, the fact that different people's brains code information slightly different. Another thing worth mentioning is that brain reading based on neuroimaging data relies on correlational models. And just because an area of the brain is active when one looks at a picture of a face, it doesn't mean that that region is necessarily involved in the particular experience. Moreover, at least for the foreseeable future, brain decoding will require full cooperation on the part of the subject. In the long run, the potential future applications for those mind-reading methods are numerous. Ideas range from communication with people with brain damage, over dream analysis, to uses in the criminal justice system. The potential ethical issues with this technology are also abundant. But this time, we will leave the discussion in your hands entirely. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing for a monthly dose of science. See you soon.